That's right. Terrible memories from the tornado that ripped through this neighborhood in 2003 came flooding back for one family who had to start from scratch.
We walked out with just us, a person, a diaper bag.
Michael and Kathy Finazzo think back to 2003.
I went downstairs and in 3 to 5 minutes, you could just hear destruction.
After an EF4 tornado tore their home apart.
It was a boulder that went through the roof, through a closet, through his wall, and it landed on my son's bed.
And turned their lives upside down.
I wanted to go through the rubble. I mean, there are things that are under here, and you want to continue to go through them, but at some point you do have to stop.
Rummaging through these photos, Kathy remembers their cars destroyed, neighbors' homes in pieces in the street.
Walls are missing in the house. There was just no fixing it.
Michael remembers a heavy burden, asking himself,
what do I do? How do I start? Where am I going to sleep tonight?
That's why they want to offer advice to people hit by the latest storm.
It's terrible. My heart goes out to these people.
Kathy says it's important to accept help.
We had friends that just offered to loan us baby beds. And, you know, here's some clothes that I got at a garage sale. Would you like them? And you really need to say, yes, I do. I really do need them right now because we don't have anything.
Michael says be patient and know the feeling of loss doesn't last forever.
It's a moment in time, and soon it will be just a memory.
It took them more than a year to get back on their property and under a new roof. That's why they can't stress enough the importance of patience in the rebuilding process. Reagan Porter, Fox 4 News.